Viewers, welcome to Learning for Knowledge channel. Today we will discuss about another aspect of reverse osmosis which is very important. We will describe the difference between arrays, passes, stages. Use these terms in the reverse osmosis plants, and these are very important to understand because some people are confusing between pass and stages. I will try to explain these things in this video. Please keep watching till end. In previous videos, we explained different terms involved in the reverse osmosis as well as the material of membrane and different types of medulla configuration available in reverse osmosis. Today we will explain the arrays, stages and passes. Now, what is membrane array? This is an arrangement of membrane pressure vessels in a specific pattern. So in an array, basically different, or you can say different, many membrane elements are arranged in stages with decreasing number of membrane elements in each succeeding stage. Now if you look in this diagram, here feed water is entering in these two RO membranes. Basically these are the membrane elements, and now in the next stage the water is entering in another RO membrane, or you can say element. So all these three membrane or this setup is called array. As you can see, that number of membranes reduced if we move from first stage to next stage. So this is called the arrangement of these types of membrane medulla or membrane elements is called arrays. Now we come towards the stages. One or two stages RO system. In one stage RO system or first stage, the feed water enters the RO system as one stream and exits the RO as either concentrate or permeates water. So this is the RO membrane. Water comes as a feed water, and there are two streams. One is clean or permeate water, and other is reject or concentrate water. This is called, if there is only one membrane medulla or element is involved or pressure vessel is installed, then this is called one stage system. Now in two stage system, the concentrate or reject from the first stage, that is from this water, becomes the feed water to the second stage. So this concentrate will enter into another membrane. The permeate water collected from the first stage, this is the permeate water collected from first stage, is combined with the permeate water from the second stage, and the reject from the second stage becomes the reject for the entire system. You can see in this figure that feed water comes and enter into these two RO membrane in stage 1. Now the permeate of these two stages collected separately, and the reject of these or concentrate of these RO membranes enter into another RO membrane. Now this RO membrane is called stage 2. Now in what happening with the impurities? Now for example, first of all we see that if we have 100 gallon per you can say 100 GPM water is entering into these two membranes, we get 50% recovery, and 50% water, that is 50 GPM gallon per minute water, becomes the product or permeate, and the remaining 50 of these two membranes which are concentrate enters into this membrane, and now 50% efficiency, 25 gallon will become the product and 25 reject. So overall efficiency in this two stage system is 75%. So you can see that important thing or important concept in this stages are that the concentrate of first stage becomes the feed of the second stage. If we have three stages, then the concentrate of the first stage becomes the feed of second stage, and the reject or concentrate of second stage becomes the feed of third stage, and reject of third stage becomes the overall reject of the system. So in this way we can increase the you can say recovery of the system. Now, if this is the symbols how we can show an array or stages, a 4-2-1 array would have three stages. You can see these represent number three stages with four pressure vessels. Number of pressure vessels in first stage are four, in second stage two, and third stage one. So you can see that number of stages, number of pressure vessels reducing in the successive, in the coming stages. So you can say this type of an array is, we can generalize, generally represent is n ratio n by 2 and then n by 4, and n is a whole number, and these are called taper or Christmas tree. This arrangement is called taper or Christmas tree configuration. The number of membrane elements in a second or third stage usually about one half the number of the elements in the preceding stage. This decrease in element is necessary. Why? Because the previous stage remove approximately 50% of the feed water, which becomes the permeate, and the half of the water is now entering in the coming stage. So to make the pressure, required pressure, to build the required pressure, we need to reduce the number of pressure vessels. So next is staging of concentrate. Increase the overall recovery while maintaining adequate cross flow in the membrane elements. So generally the permeate recovery rates for 1, 2, 3 stage arrays, 6 40 inch long membrane elements per pressure vessel is as given below. If we have only one stage, we get 50% recovery. If we have two stages, now recovery becomes 75%, and for three stages recovery is 85%. This is the diagram. You can say 100 gallon per minute enters in these two stages, again repeating this thing. Now if we have 100 ppm, you can say TDS or impurities present in the feed water, then after passing from stage 1, you can see if it's assuming that 98% rejection of the salt, 2 ppm will go into this permeate, and 200 approximately, you can say, because it's double concentration factor, due to concentration factor this is 200 approximately, and now this will enter into second stage. And then again assuming 98% rejection, so you can say that only 4 ppm will be, we get 4 ppm water in this permeate, and when we add these two permeates, the final product TDS is 2.67 ppm, which is good quality water, and all of the rejects contain approximately 400 ppm of the salts or TDS. So this is the way in which water purification process proceed. Now we comes to another important term, passes. Some people normally confuses in stage and passes. Now here we are looking about the passes. So RO system that are designed to retreat permeate from a single pass, RO system by reverse osmosis multiple times are termed multiple pass RO system. What this means is that in the previous, you can say, stages definition, or in stages, the concentrate from first stage enter into second stage, but in passes the permeate from first pass enter into the become the feed water of the second pass. This is the difference, that in stages we feed concentrate, in passes we feed permeate. So single pass RO versus double pass RO. Difference between a single pass RO system and double pass RO system is that, as I already explained, the permeate from first pass becomes the feed of the second pass. And due to this feeding of the permeate into second pass, we get much higher quality water permeate at the final stages. And recovery of the second pass can be as high as 90% with only two stages. So if we have two stages, so we can get a 90% of the recovery, and in using the two pass system. So this high recovery can be achieved because the relatively low concentration of dissolved solid in the influent to the second pass. So basically what I want to say here, that if we have a two pass system and each pass at two stages, we can get a water of 90%, you can say recovery of the 90%, very small rejection of the water. So this is single pass RO, which is similar to that of first stage RO, because there is no difference in one stage or single pass RO. But for double pass RO, we can see that up to this point, from here, this is the first pass and this is the second pass. So feed water and to enter into the RO, two RO module, or you can say pressure vessel. Now these two RO pressure vessel become first stage, but it is the part of, it is the part of RO first pass. Now the concentrate enters into the this membrane or pressure vessel, and the product water is now fed to the go to the second pass. This is the second pass. Blue line shows the product, red line shows the reject. And then the product from the second pass, now this at this stage, first pass is completed, and each pass, one pass has two stages. This is the difference, that the stages or stage are the subset of the pass. And this is the second pass, and you can get a higher quality water, best quality water in these two passes system. So, and recovery also become improved because the concentrate of this second pass is relatively better, because here we are getting much higher quality water is feeding in this in these membranes. So the reject or concentrate is recycled back to here to the feed water. Now advantages of two pass systems. First advantage is it produce higher quality permeate and allow direct use in 600 to 900 psi boiler. This is a very important advantage. Now recovery of the second pass can be as high as 90% with only two stages. You can say if we install more stages, three stages, then we get approximately 87% recovery. But by adopting this two pass, two stages system, we get 90% recovery because of the relatively low concentration of dissolved solid in the influent of the second pass. Now, this is another very important advantage of these two pass. Now, we can easily remove the carbon dioxide which is dissolved in the permeate or product water if we install two pass system, because in the intermediate stages we feed sodium hydroxide or caustic, and it will remove the CO2. Basically the CO2 present in the permeate water of the first pass, now pH increases due to sodium hydroxide and it is converted into carbonate and bicarbonate, which can be easily rejected in the second pass. Why we are doing this? Because CO2 is undesirable for electrodeionizing system or mixed bed ion exchange reason, and these are normally installed after the reverse osmosis plant. For very high quality of water which will be fed in supercritical boilers which required very high quality of water, and CO2 is undesirable. So this is a good we get a very good opportunity by removing CO2 by installing two pass system. Otherwise, if we don't install this CO2, which later on become the carbonate or bicarbonate, and this will increase the scaling in the system. And other thing is at the end is recycle. So in recycling, a concentrate is recycled and usually used in smaller RO system where the cross flow velocity is not high, because we need a cross flow velocity across the membrane. So to build up the pressure and increase the velocity, we recycle the concentrate. Now advantage of recycle. Recycle of the concentrate to the feed increase the cross flow, of course, and reducing the risk of fouling, because when velocity increases, it will remove the salts present or stopped at the membrane surface. And disadvantage of the recycle, overall low overall product quality. Why? Because we are adding more TDS which are rejected in the concentrate. Now we are recycling back in the feed of the RO. So that's why low quality water. And large feed pump requirement means higher energy consumption and higher capital cost, because the RO feed pump must now pressurize both the influent stream plus the recycled reject stream. These are some disadvantages. So in this short presentation or in this video, we try to explain the difference basically between pass and stages and advantages of this pass system. Now in a big RO system, normally these passes are used and very beneficial towards the recovery as well as the highest quality of water. Thank you very much, and if you still have any question, you can ask by commenting in the video, and please don't forget to like and subscribe the channel. Thank you very much.